shot this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot at this.
match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot. This.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot. This.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot. This.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot.
Hello and welcome to the featuring Division 5 championship game in the Central Section with the Firebaugh Eagles and the Caruthers Blue Raiders. The Eagles coming in with an overall record of 23-8, 9-1 in league, and the Blue Raiders 24-3-1, also 9-1 in league. The Firebaugh Eagles co-champs, and Caruthers beat Fowler twice in the first time in a long time to get that first round seed. And by my partner, also basketball head coach down at Patrick Henry down in San Diego. Coach, what do you tell these players in a championship game?
Hey, man, you got to leave it all out there first and foremost. People like to say it's just another game. It's not another game. It's a Division 5 championship game for your section title. You got to bring it, and that's what we're going to see between these two outstanding ball clubs today.
That's my partner in crime, Robert Fields, getting all the great footage. Dan Stewart. We'll get to lineups and defensive positioning in a bit. But leading off for the Fireball Eagles is none other than their star catcher, Juan Garcia, takes that curveball in the dirt, ball one, in the two spot. Playing shortstop, Brandon Sosa, number three, in the number two batting in the third spot, Danny Perez. Cleanup, Josh Allen, batting in the fifth spot, Alex Loza. Steven Aguayo in the sixth. Jordan Martinez batting seventh as the pitcher Steven Guerra evens the count 1-1. Batting eighth, Anthony Valdez, and rounding it off in the lineup, center fielder number three, Tristan Diedrich. Steven Guerra, off-speed pitches is the name of his game. Coming back with another breaking ball on the outer half. Gets ahead in the count 1-2. It's the off-speed stuff, and later in this game, we'll see their star pitcher, one of the better ones we'll see in a long time, Mr. Cornelius, who bats third. That one's hit to center field. Looks like it's going to drop, and it will. Right in front of Christian Arredondo. That catch, that second pitcher I was talking about with the plus stuff is Dallin Cornelius. But on the mound currently is Steven Guerra. And the first runner on, Juan Garcia with the base hit.
Yeah, outstanding. Just making contact. You know, get a little bloop hit. That's what you want to do as a leadoff hitter is get on base, give the rest of your guys the opportunity to get something going.
And don't be surprised if you see a lot of bloop, a lot of eye-seeing singles in this ball game with the off-speed pitch. Juan Garcia, nice leadoff on first. The speedster is one of the reasons why he is a leadoff man.
And that's what you want to do. You see that already. He's on base right now. Now he already has a pitcher checking him out. He's already kind of messing up the flow of it. We have two throws right back to first base. So already getting the pitcher a little bit off of his game.
Garcia, the 1-0 pitch. Another breaking ball outside. He's going to see a lot of that today. Guerra relying on his off-speed stuff, looking to keep these batters off-balanced. Two-one pitch. And Sosa takes that one low.
I believe batter's taking this one. 3-0 count, hitter's count. He's going to walk him.
And a tough start for Guerra. Fireball getting their first two batters on base. And in the third spot, the pitcher, number two, Danny Perez, can get this game started early with a base hit. Fireball, 23-8, 9-1 in league. Once again, the breaking ball, fouled tip. And Guerra will get in the head of the count, 0-1. This one's hit down the third baseline. Tough hop. Gets by Undlund. And the first run of the game as Garcia crosses the plate. Tough chop to handle by Undlund. It's one of those balls where you're either going to charge or step back. Usually you want to be aggressive on those balls. Undlund took the step back.
I think Undlund was ready to make the play, try to get a double play, unassisted double play by tagging third base and kind of got ahead of himself there.
Almost like one step ahead right there. You're right, Robert. Cleanup hitter, Josh Allen now at bat. Takes a breaking ball, smacks that one into left field. Rounding third is Sosa, and Fireball out with the 2-0 lead here in the top of the first. They're all over the off-speed stuff right now.
Yeah, it's so easy for them right now. They're seeing the ball come off the pitcher's hand. They're timing it perfectly and just getting good contact and putting it in the field of play.
It's tough. The off-speed pitch is a good pitch, but when you don't have a backup pitch like a fastball, it's hard to keep them off balance. Right now, the batters are just sitting on the breaking stuff as Alex Loza steps into the batter's box, number five batter. Still no outs here. Two runs across in the top of the first. And that one will find the outer half for the first strike.
Yeah, not the start Caruthers wanted going into this ball game. Kind of getting peppered already with giving up two base hits.
Yeah, as you saw in the last one, cleanup hitter Josh Allen way out in front, but got just enough bat on it. This one popped up behind Fight, unable to get to it. Count will go 0-2. Trying to get runners in scoring position. They already have one, but second and third with one out. That's what it looked like Coach Salcedo was trying to get done. Fireball, a veteran squad, seven seniors and two juniors starting. Their catcher was the MVP of the league. That was our leadoff hitter, Juan Garcia. Alex Loza, on the 0-2 count, takes the breaking ball inside. Tried to almost turn to take that one off the shoulder. Not a bad idea down in the count, 0-2.
Yeah, got a little lean in there. He wasn't worried about the movement on it. Just said, hey, if it's going to hit me, it's going to hit me.
And if you're going to get hit, you might as well get hit by a breaking ball, yep. Especially one going away from you. Another breaking ball has Loza out in front, and the first out of the game goes with a swinging strikeout.
That's what the pitcher needed there. Get somebody, one of the first batters you can get to retire, and now see if you can't get in a groove here. And not worry about the runners on base. Just repeat the success that you just had in that last batter.
Now a bat designated hitter number 13, Steven Aguayo, calls quick time. The pitch. Aguayo checked on the swing. They're going to check down first baseline. And the bat control of Aguayo didn't cross the plate. And Aguayo, it's difficult. You want to be ahead in the count with a breaking ball pitcher. When you fall behind, you almost have to rely on that fastball. Obviously not his pitch. We've seen somewhere in the vicinity of 15 to 20 pitches, the majority of them, if not all of them, have been breaking balls. Aguayo trying to keep the base runners close. That's another thing you have to worry about with the off-speed pitcher. Ball takes longer to get to the plate, allowing runners to get a nice lead. Nice secondary lead, especially on second. And Aguayo having difficulty finding the strike zone right here. Throws that one in the dirt.
Yeah, Aguayo has only been ahead in the count on one batter so far. So he's kind of really all over the place as that one, again, misses the mark.
Yeah, it looked like he tried to come back with a fastball right there. Didn't have the squeeze for it, came out of his hands. Once again, another ball in the dirt. And the hitter's count for Aguayo. He's in here for one reason. That's the hit. As a designated hitter, takes that ball outside, and he will go down to first. Not the start that you wanted for Caruthers, the number one seeded team, as that's the second walk in the inning. First walk to Brandon Sosa, number two hitter who came around to score. Now the base is juiced. Coach Clark tried to calm his kids down, calm the nerves. This can be an intense game in a championship game.
Absolutely, and this is as Coach Clark is going to do out here now. He's going to, hey, we've already given him some runs. Let's not worry about that. Let's not, you know, try not to succumb to the pressure of the situation at hand, but let's stay calm, stay controlled. Let's get outs. Let's make him put the ball on the ground. Let's make a play in the field and get a force, you know, obviously being a bases loaded, to get a force where the force is and try to get out of this inning as quick as possible now.
Yeah, you want to cut down. You want to make this a minimum inning. You don't want this to be a five-run inning. Two runs, maybe even three runs, still a lot of ball game to be played, especially with the hot hitting of Caruthers. Caruthers known throughout the county as a big hitting team. So two or three runs down in the first, not a big deal. But five or six, and then you're talking a different story. As a good job by Guerin battling back, getting that first pitch strike across on the inner half. Jordan Martinez in the box, number 25, their third baseman, the 1-0 pitch.
I'm chasing on that one.
He tried to poke that one out of the stadium right there. Way out in front. Right now, you don't need a big hit.
No.
You just need a base. A base hit will drive in two runs.
Well, we talk about the pitcher not being antsy. We got the batter has to not be antsy as well in a situation. You know, you want to do so well for your ball clip here.
The 0-2 pitch. Pop straight up. Fight has a good ground on it and brings that one in for the second out. And like you said, Robert, good job just making the batters hit the ball, let your defense make the plays.
Yeah, well, that one I think he was a little antsy at the plate.
Martinez.
He wanted to get something done for
right.
His team there. You know, you see bases loaded, a section title game. I'm going to get up here and knock as many of these guys in as possible. And you saw him chasing a couple of those pitches.
And that's one thing you hear as well is you're almost trying to do too much as this one's popped up to right field. And Cornelius catches that one for the third out. The damage done, but not by much. With bases loaded and only one out, Fireball brings in two at the end of one or at half of the end of one, Fireball 2, and Caruthers with their first at-bat on your home for high school sports, playonsports.com. Heading in the bottom of the first. Fireball out with their early 2-0 lead off of two hits, one error, and a couple walks. Batted eight batters through the first. Could have added more, but the great pitching by Guerra and battling back.
Yeah.
Only allowed two runs.
And I think that's it, Guerra. He settled down, you know, and it was unfortunate he kind of got peppered there and got an error on his defense, the guys behind him. But he was able to settle down there and get out of that inning without further damage.
Leading it off for the Blue Raiders, number three, Elijah Clark, their star shortstop, as he takes the first pitch strike. And 85 at-bats during the regular season. Doesn't have the batting average. 458. As he falls in the count 0-2. Defense for Fireball. Going left to right, Anthony Valdez, Tristan Diedrich, and Alec Loza. Third baseman, Jordan Martinez. As Clark swings at that one, misses. And the throw down to first by Garcia. Gets the first out of the game. Here in the bottom of the first.
Yeah, those first two pitches, I think he was on the take, and they were coming right down the pipe. I don't know if you got to get the bat off your shoulders, young man, and make a play happen.
Number two batter, Danny Arciaga. Sometimes as a leadoff hitter, you want to see the first couple pitches. You want to make the pitcher work, but at the same time.
Hey, if those are coming right down the pipe, man, that's in your wheelhouse. You got to put some contact on it, I think.
The table setter, Arciaga. Once again, Perez. 82-86 on the fastball, four pitches. Likes to change it up with the knuckleball every once in a while when he's feeling it. Breaking ball high. Count goes 1-2. The lineup for the Blue Raiders, Steven Guerra in the number three spot, batting cleanup, Alante Ribe. This one drilled to the right side, goes foul. Number five batter, Kaysen Fight. Number six, Dallin Cornelius. In the seventh spot, Jared Green. Batting in eighth spot, number 21, Matt Unland. And cleaning it up in the lineup. Number nine batter, looks like as Arciaga went around, is Christian Arredondo. Two batters, two up, two down, both swinging, strikeouts. And the pitcher right now, going to try to help his cause, Steven Guerra, up at the plate.
And some confidence at the plate here by Guerra. Can transition to the mound, I believe.
Breaking ball outside. Takes that for a ball. Five sophomores, two juniors, Caruthers starts. So a fairly young squad. And when you have a younger squad, sometimes it's a little difficult to come back. It's always nice to play ahead. But it's always a mental game, but it becomes much more mental down early. As Guerra takes second pitch for a strike. 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Good job by Danny Perez in attacking the strike zone. Brandon Sosa, their star shortstop. Carlos Navarro, their second baseman. And Josh Allen, their first baseman. And the defense surrounded by their star catcher and league MVP, Juan Garcia. Danny Perez on the hill. Attacking the strike zone, making his defense work for him. This one hit between the hole. Has a chance to throw him out at first. A slow pitcher running down Guerra. The ball beat him there, but unfortunately overthrown by Loza. Nice backup by Garcia, not allowing Guerra to get to second. And their cleanup hitter, first baseman number 13, Alante Riba, now at bat. And he could tie this ball game up with one swing.
Well, that's not going to be the swing right there as he went over the top of that one.
Perez starting him off with a breaking ball. Throws that one down to first. Uribe. Batting 500 on the season during the regular season. It's about as good as it gets.
Yeah.
So almost two hits every game. You figure number three hitter gets about four or five at-bats per game. You're hitting 400. 500, you're getting about two, three hits a game. He has four home runs on the season, leading the squad as he fouls that one back. Falls in the count 0-2. Perez doing a good job of attacking the strike zone, talking to Coach Salcedo before the game. He said, we like to attack the strike zone. Perez is a pitcher that attacks the strike zone and lets his defense do the work. And we've seen that today as the count goes even, 2-2. Two-two pitch. This one hitting the 5.5 hole, also known as the Baltimore chop. You don't hear that too often, but whenever the ball bounces on the plate or near the plate, bounces over a third baseman's head, it's considered a Baltimore chop. We are here on the West Coast. Many may not have known that. Not trying to sound like a smart guy or anything, but it's just one of those things.
We'll just call it a Fresno chop from here on out.
We're
in the local vicinity here, or the Valley chop, as these guys are really playing for this Division 5 title here in Corona, California.
Beautiful day for baseball. First pitch fouled off. Kaysen Fight, the catcher, with runners on first and second and two outs. Perez doing a good job in getting the first two batters out, striking out, swinging, and now two base hits given up as this one crosses high. Evens the count 1-1. Those weren't solid hits either. They're just seeing-eye singles. The 1-1 pitch. Fight takes that one the other way. Down the line, it'll go foul. 1-2, Perez has been working well ahead in the count. Showing decent breaking stuff, but comes down to his plus fastball, topping off at 86. Fight on the season in 85 plate appearances, batting .447, 31 runs, 23 RBIs. Make that 33 RBIs. Second on the team behind Elijah Clark, who has 39. This one fouled off down the right field line once again. Fight doesn't strike out much. He'll bat it at the plate, wait for a good pitch, mistake pitch. Looking to drive one to the gap right here to bring in two, tie the ball game up. Breaking ball outside, in the dirt, nice side by Fight. Not the greatest speed on second. We almost saw Guerra get gunned out at first. If the throw was on point, he might have got him and ended the inning. Nonetheless, two outs, two runners on. Fight, breaking ball, strike three, swinging. Off of two hits, three strikeouts. That will end the first inning with Fireball up 2-0 on your home for high school sports. Play on sports.com. Hello, and thank you for staying with us here on PlayOnSports.com, your destination for high school sports. I'm Bo Furtick alongside my partner Robert Fields, Dan Stewart on the camera, on the video, however you want to say it. Stepping in the box is the number 9 batter, Fireball, brought up 8 batters in the first. Number 3, Tristan Diedrich. Guerra minimized the first inning, only allowing 2. This one grounded over to shortstop. Elijah Clark throws over the first for the first out of the inning. Mark that in the books, 6-3.
That's what Guerrero needed. Just get up there, make the guy, you know, you let your defense carry you a little bit. You know, let them put the ball in play and allow your defense to do what it's supposed to be doing out there.
In the first inning, Guerrero allowed the first four base runners to get on base. One of them was due to an error. But he gets the first batter out right there. Regains some confidence in this young stud. Another off-speed pitch outside. Back at the top. The star catcher, the MVP of the league, number 5, Juan Garcia, who's batting also .500 on the season. We have a couple guys from both squads batting an even .500. That's about as good as it gets at this level in the Division 5 Central Section Championship game. Guerra, the pitch, drives that one left center, and it will fall in for a base hit. Looked like he caught it off the end of the bat, but got just enough of it, Garcia did, for a second base hit of the day. And the shortstop, number 4, Brandon Sosa, stepping up to the plate. Walked in his first plate appearance. Ended up coming around to score the second run in the first. Garcia with a nice leadoff. Guerra outside. Sosa squared around a bunt. Pulled back quickly.
And Guerrero looked like he's falling off the mound there a little bit on that last pitch.
Yeah, if I don't know if you could see it on the camera, but the steps where the pitchers are stepping way over to first.
Yeah, you see some fresh dirt there. That was Guerrero's previous pitch before that one where he really fell all the way off to that first baseline.
Sometimes pitchers, younger pitchers, overcompensate for trying to hit the outside zone, the outer third of the plate. And it's actually a tip towards the batters. If you see a pitcher stepping out that wide, there's no way he's coming inside on you. And you kind of saw that with Juan Garcia, the leadoff batter. He kind of leaned into that pitch and drove it to left field. You don't see an outside pitch drilled like that and pulled unless the batter's hovering over the plate. And Fireball hitter's doing a good job in following the pitch all the way to the glove. Someone like a Pete Rose. Pete Rose was notorious for that. Almost walking to the other side of the box, watching the ball go into the glove.
Are you liking these young Fireball players to Pete Rose?
They do. They are wearing the same colors. Pete Rose like. Brandon Sosa lines that one to Arciaga. Arciaga doing a good job. Almost had Garcia at first, but a nice heads-up play by Garcia and getting back in time, bouncing off his shoe. Nonetheless, two outs with Danny Perez coming up. He dribbled one down the third baseline, and Unland had a difficult time with it. Unland, check swing, went around for a strike. Garcia on first still, looking to get in scoring position with the number 3 batter up. I'm surprised he hasn't left yet with the off-speed pitch from Guerra.
I think he might have just caught it.
That's a high fastball. Try to sneak a fastball by him. But Perez was all over that one. Didn't even flinch. And I think they were looking for the steal as well. One of the reasons why he came back with the fastball. The 1-1 pitch. Once again, outside breaking ball. Guerra working that outer third. And that's what you do with your off-speed pitcher. You want the batters to get out in front and roll their hands over to either the third baseman or shortstop. The 2-1 pitch. Garcia off and running. This one fouled back. Not sure if that was a stolen base or a hit and run. I'm guessing at this point it was a straight stolen base, and Perez liked what he saw. Fouled it back, and the count goes at 2-2. Perez on the season batting .423 with a couple home runs. Looks that one outside. That's a full count. Garcia will be in motion with two outs.
Garcia, again, has some speed out there. I'm surprised his lead isn't a lot bigger than what it is.
Garcia gets back plenty of time. Guerra, not the quickest player on the field, obviously. And with his off-speed stuff, Cason Fite definitely has his work cut out for him. The 3-2 pitch. It's a shortstop, Clark. Clark over to first. The pick. Unable to pick it up was Atlante Uribe. And a difficult throw by Clark, who usually makes that play on a consistent basis, 9 out of 10 times. And unfortunately, an error in the first resulting in the two runs. And now an error here with two outs has runners second and third with the cleanup batter coming up. Number six, Josh Allen. If you're Allen, you're obviously sitting breaking ball and you're sitting on the outer half of the plate. As Guerra has definitely attacked the outer third through an inning and two-thirds. Allen, breaking ball, takes it outside. With first base open, they might be trying to pitch around him.
I was going to say that. Allen, the last time up, he was on the first swing, he was ready to rock and got a base hit. The last time he was up. So, you know, being a big-time hitter, you may pitch around him just a little bit here.
Allen, back to the pitcher. Guerra gets that one cleanly and minimizes the damage once again, allowing no runs on one hit. At the end of one and a half, score remains 2-0. Fireball in your home for high school sports. Play on sports.com. The designated hitter facing Cornelius for the first time. Cornelius came into the fourth inning after sophomore Steven Guerra allowed three runs on four hits in three innings pitched. Cornelius is their ace. He's the go-to guy. Just doesn't start games off too well. This one just misses. Cornelius, 11-1 on the season. So definitely their go-to guy here late in the ballgame. Fastball crosses the plate for strike one. Steven Aguayo looking that one in all the way. Still hitters count. Guayo, designated hitter. 2-1 pitch. Breaking ball outside. Has Aguayo swinging. Evens the count 2-2. Like I said, beautiful day here. The city of Caruthers. Caruthers High. The 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball catches the inside corner for Cornelius' second strikeout of the game. This one has Aguayo looking. Jordan Martinez, the third baseman, coming up to plate. One of two on the day. Second at bat, smacked one over the left field fence for the third run of the game. That's a fastball outside for ball one. Cornelius looking to stay away from the power hitting Martinez, looking to attack the outer third of the plate. Breaking ball outside, has Martinez out in front, chops out one behind home plate. Martinez just got his pitch when he was facing sophomore Stevie Guerra. Breaking ball, that didn't break much. Hang him and bang him, that's what Martinez did. Looks at this breaking ball high, and Cornelius falls in the count, 2-1. Had a rocky first. Or Rocky fourth, his first inning in the fourth, did Cornelius. Now in his second inning pitching. This one smacked again to left. It has the, I almost thought Jared Green came down with that, and so did everyone else. It had the distance, and it went. Green went up with that one. Almost brought it back, and Martinez with two home runs on the day, giving Fireball a 4-0 lead. Once again, another breaking ball. You hang him, he bangs him. He's done that twice today. once in the third, and his second home run here in the fifth. Fireball out to a 4-0 lead. Green almost came down with that one. The crowd was silenced. No one knew what had happened. Green timed that one just right, but unable to come down with it and bring it back. And Martinez, two identical pitches, two identical swings, and the same results.
Well, Bo, as I join the broadcast back now, you're right. He sold it that he almost caught it because he just came back down on nonchalantly, and then everybody's looking to see, okay, is he going to show us the ball or what? And once he didn't show the ball, everybody realized that ball just went over out of outside of his glove.
Yeah, he couldn't have missed it by much. I was almost going to say home run at one point, and I saw Green go over, and it's not a good thing. As broadcast, let that one play out. Green timed it just right. This time Green had a chance to get back. He lost it in the sun a little bit. You can tell somewhat of a stutter step to get back to the fence. But he should have known off the bat that one was going far. As an outfielder, first thing you want to do when you see the ball go over your head is just run straight towards the fence and look back. And Jared Green, instead of running straight towards the fence, looked up, then started running back. And that split second was a difference between a home run and an out as Anthony Valdez strikes out swinging for the second strikeout of the inning. That is three strikeouts on the day for Dallin Cornelius. And now the number nine batter, Tristan Diedrich, stepping up to the plate. Breaking ball catches the corner for a first strike. Diedrich, 1-for-2 on the day as he fouls out one down the first baseline. Grounded out to shortstop in the second and ripped a single up the middle in the fourth. Now off the bat here in the fifth. With no on, two outs, Cornelius, the 0-1 pitch. Now the count, 1-1. Diedrich, the number nine batter, but brings a good stick to the plate, batting over 300. The swing and miss. Three strikeouts. Cornelius strikes out the side on top of the fifth, but allows a home run by Jordan Martinez. And Fireball with a 4-0 lead heading in the bottom of fifth on your home for high school sports. Heading in the bottom of the fifth, Danny Perez cruising through four, throwing a two-hitter. Now with the bottom of the lineup coming up, number seven hitter, Jared Green, ground out to short in his first at-bat, fouls that one back for strike one. Perez has been attacking the strike zone all day long, allowing two hits and five strikeouts through four. This one, fastball outside, fouled right back. Green was on that one. Just unable to hit that one between the lines. And Perez, once again, out in front. The 0-2 pitch. Breaking ball outside. Home plate umpire gave this swing. And the sixth strikeout on the day for Danny Perez. It's about, I want to say, about half of the strikeouts in this ball game have come off of check swings. One of the reasons is Danny Perez is attacking the strike zone. The hitters are falling in the count. And when that happens, you tend to swing at bad pitches. And Perez is just finding the strike zone with anything. Fastball, changeup, breaking ball.
He's in an absolute groove right now. And you got to just start fouling something off. Get him looking away at some of these balls as you get a little dribbler here.
This one grounded over to short. But the great play by Sosa. Sosa has been a stud at shortstop today, picking everything up. That's been the one difference here in this ballgame. A couple errors by Caruthers, allowing a few runs. And on the other hand, Fireball playing great defense. And that's one thing Coach Salcedo said was, we rely on our defense. The batters put the ball in play with Perez attacking the strike zone, and our defense backs up our pitcher. And that's what they're doing today with the number nine batter up, Christian Arredondo, coming up. At bat, dribbles out one to the pitcher. Once again, another three up, three down for Perez as he's cruising through five.
Yeah, you can just see the look on his face as he walks off and talks to everybody. Yeah, he is in an absolute groove out there.
Heading to the top of the sixth. Fireball looking to extend their 4-0 lead on your home for high school sports. PlayOnSports.com. Having fun up here in the box. I hope all you fans at home are having as much fun as we are having up here in the city of Caruthers. My first time, beautiful experience, beautiful day here on this Friday afternoon. Beautiful day for baseball, high blue skies. And the top of the sixth, Fireball, 4-0 lead, two home runs off the bat of Jordan Martinez, both solo shots. Dallin Cornelius still on the mound, leading it off, the leadoff hitter. And league MVP catcher Juan Garcia. Garcia batting .500 on the season.
And we talk about the groove that Perez is in for Fireball, but Garcia is also doing a great job at back there behind calling the pitches for him and then making sure the flow is good. So kudos to him, and then that goes to some of his leadership. You know, you don't get league MVP by being a slouch.
Right, and as a leadoff hitter, you rarely see catchers play the leadoff bat in the leadoff position. This one hit high to deep center. Arredondo on the run tracks that one down nicely for the first out here in the top of the sixth.
Yeah, he tracked that down absolutely right. And like you said, he was a little turned around. He started going towards left field a little bit and then did a little 360 and found his way back going towards right field after that.
The big thing was he turned around the right way. Instead of turning his back towards the fence, he turned it towards the infield. And if you turn the other way, no way he gets that ball. Brandon Sosa now at bat, the shortstop, the star-studded shortstop, making all the plays thus far at short. In three at-bats today, a walk, line to second, and Cade in the fourth. This one, dribbler up the middle, and once again, Elijah Clark, usually solid at shortstop, just today, mentally. It's a tough game, Robert Fields. It's a very tough game out there. When you make one or two errors in the beginning of the game, it tends to follow you. And when you're at this level mentally, it's very difficult to climb back. But they got to start it here. Down 4-0. Danny Perez now at bat. The pitcher. 1-3. 1-4-3 today. Takes that first pitch outside for a ball. Perez dribbled one down third baseline for an error. Smoked one to left field for a single. And had another pitch, or another hit, to shortstop. That was Clark's second error on the day. So he's reached base all three times, two coming on errors. But nonetheless, if you're getting on base, you're getting on base. No matter how you slice or dice it. One out. Sosa on first. Cornelius, the pitch. Breaking ball outside.
Like you say, he's getting on base. He's just helping his cause out. He's just helping his cause, you know, make these guys stay in the field a little bit longer so when they're coming up to face him and he's throwing all this gas out here and guys aren't catching up with it. They're exhausted.
Inside pitch. Finds the corner for strike two. Perez didn't like that one, but he can't say much because he is the pitcher. For Fireball, swing and a miss for strike three. Good job by Cornelius in battling back for his fifth strikeout on the day here in 2 1/3. Now cleanup hitter, first baseman Josh Allen, as Cornelius tries to keep Sosa close, throwing the ball over to first. Allen, 1-2 on the day, singled in the first, lined out to first, and walked in the fourth. Singled in the first, lined in the second, and walked in the fourth. Two outs. Runner on first. That's Sosa. Stays put. This one smacked to left field, line drive. But hit right to green. Didn't have to move much. No runs. No hits. One error. Heading into the bottom of the sixth. Fireball is still up. 4-0 on your home for high school sports. Play on sports.com. Thank you for staying tuned with us here on PlayOnSports.com, your destination for high school sports. I'm Bo Furtick alongside my partner in crime, Robert Fields, doing a great job of the techno work, keeping you guys here in the game. Well, and then the cameraman, Dan Stewart.
Want to keep them engaged, but I think this is going to be a big inning for the Blue Raiders. You know, they're six outs away from you know, this being over and done, and the time is now for them to try to get some hits, start like they did in that first inning. Get a couple guys on base. Just see what happens after that.
This will be the third time around. The Caruthers Blue Raiders facing Danny Perez, who's looking for his 13th win on the season. Cruising through five, allowing two hits with six strikeouts. And really, he's dominated the top of this lineup. Elijah Clark and Danny Arcega, two of their top hitters. Four plate appearances, four strikeouts. That's how you keep a great hitting team in check. Getting the first couple guys out and letting your defense do the rest.
Yeah, you keep them in check while they're sitting on that bench. They're not up at the plate.
Breaking ball outside, rolled down third baseline, foul. Caruthers, 24-3-1, 9-1 in league. Beat Fowler twice to become league champions. Team motto, blue collar teams, bring your lunch pails, community. It's all about community on this team. This one hit up the middle. Sosa once again all over the place for the first out. Sosa doing a great job.
Yeah, he covered a little bit of range on that play there. He was all the way almost on the other side of second base when he got to that one. So he was on the move. And that just speaks to his athletic ability, obviously playing shortstop, but able to get that ball right off the bat and go grab it.
Yeah, it was a slow roller up the middle. Did a good job in attacking it. Breaking ball, first pitch strike. Number two hitter, Danny Arcega. Third time around, Danny Perez doing it all. Curveball, fastball, changeup. He has his hitters off balance right now. The count 1-1. And the pitch, breaking ball, pulled. And Sosa diving just gets by him. I would have loved to see Sosa get up and throw him out. It would have been a difficult chance, though. Difficult with Arcega, the speedster, going down the first baseline. That's only the third hit allowed through 5 1/3. And the number three batter, Stevie Gara. I mean, like you said, Robert, this is the inning right here.
Yeah.
Top of the lineup. Now heading to the heart of the lineup. 3, 4, 5 batters coming up with a runner on. Maybe not all four runs in this inning, but you're at least looking to cut the deficit in half.
Well, you got to be extremely aggressive right now if you're Caruthers. You go up there ready to hack, ready to put some balls in play.
Danny Perez, somewhat economical in this game. With 6 strikeouts, though. Pitch count somewhat high here in the 6th. Looking for his 13th win on the season. Coach Salcedo, Fireball, loves what he sees out of this kid. And how could you not after
Absolutely.
Watching this game?
And with the outstanding defense behind him.
Yeah, Sosa has been a vacuum out there at shortstop. This one fouled straight back.
I was ready to catch that one, man.
I know you were.
To catch it.
I was looking to get out of the way on that one. That could have been all you right there. Steve Igara, throw over to first. Arcega gets back easily. No sun between the plate and the mound. Clear skies here today on a beautiful Friday. Breaking ball inside. Arcega wanted that one to rub off his shoulders. Tried to squeeze that one a little bit. Unable to. Perez, the breaking ball outside. Gara has worked this count back in his favor. Arcega with the base hit on first. The pitch, high fastball.
He almost turned into that one.
Here's a lesson for our youngsters.
Uh-oh. Instructor Bo here.
Well, when you turn on a pitch like that and you don't move, it obviously didn't hit you.
Yeah.
When you turn on a pitch like that and it hits the bat or whatever, you are jumping up and down, falling to the ground. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Nonetheless, Gar will take that one. What do you know, Bo? I'm a hitter. I'm a number three hitter. I don't take cheap base on balls hit by pitches. I smacked the ball at the middle for a base hit.
Yeah, I told you this was an inning right here, and you got to believe that when they got ready to come out to this inning, he says, "Hey, this is where it's at for us. You know, we figured this guy out now. Let's just put the ball in play and see what happens."
Gara. Batting .500 on the season, one of the reasons why he didn't fall down crying like a little baby like I would have. Alante Uribe also batting .500 on the season. This one looked good off the bat, but you could tell by the sound just off the end of the bat in front of the breaking ball. And Perez really has done a good job of that all day. It caught the middle part of the plate. But because he's kept these batters off balance all day, off the end of the bat, take that all day.
And I believe the last time they had two runners stranded was the very first inning. So
you are correct, my friend.
They got to get somebody over there and on that third bag and try to work them in home.
Perez hasn't allowed a runner to get to third base and looks like he won't through six. The great play off the mound, and this team is rallying around this superstar stud. An hour and a half into this ball game, cruising along here in the top of the seventh. Fireball looking to add some insurance runs, up 4-0. Danny Perez cruising through six, allowing four hits and no runs. Has shut out this great hitting Caruthers team. And the 5-6-7 batters coming up for Fireball. Second year head coach Eric Salcedo has to like what he's seeing out of his squad through the first six. One more inning to be crowned Division 5 Central Section Champions.
You have success like this in your second year. You think, and I could do this easily now. Why did I get started so late?
This one dribbled over the second. One pitch, one out. Mark that in the books. 4-3. This veteran team, number two seed Fireball, seven seniors, two juniors. So seniors want to go out on a high note. Breaking ball fouled back for a first pitch strike. Dallin Cornelius came into the fourth inning. He's only allowed one run on a couple hits. Steven Aguayo, designated hitter. Batting the sixth spot, up at bat, takes that ball, evens the count at 1-1. That's pinch hitter Jason Allen, a diving play by Edlund, unable to throw him out. That was a pinch hitter, number 10. Jason Allen, the sophomore, gets on base with the base hit. Looks like we'll have a pinch runner for Allen. Looks like number 9, Matt Diarcos, the senior. And now, Jordan Martinez walking up to the plate. 2-for-3 on the day, two of those hits, knocking him over the left field fence. Both home runs coming off of inside pitches. So if you're Cornelius, you're attacking the outer third right now. Does on that pitch, misses the corner for ball one. Jordan Martinez really has been that spark on offense. Fireball, two runs in the top of the first. From the first two batters, Garcia and Sosa. And Caruthers' pitcher is doing a good job in minimizing the damages Fireball has left some runners in scoring position. But when you hit home runs, good things tend to happen. Fireball up 4-0 off of two solo shots by Martinez. Takes that outside pitch. Martinez, you can just tell he's seeing the ball well right now. He's not flinching on balls out of the zone. And balls that are in the zone, he's letting them rip. Cornelius, the pitch. Fastball low. Count goes to 3-1. Martinez has hit a few home runs, but you don't really want to pitch around him. Because with a pinch runner, DeArcos on first, he's not going to score on a base hit. But he will now after the walk to Martinez.
Well, the reason you don't want to really pinch around him because you're already in a bind as it is, being down 4-0, and you just want to get out of this inning and give yourself one final chance to put something on the board. You don't want to give them any type of insurance runs.
And another pinch hitter here in the top of the seventh, senior, standing at 6'3", number 23, Francisco Cuevas. Runners on first and second, one out. Looking to add some insurance runs. That ball catches the corner for a first strike. Cuevas, right-handed pitcher, also plays center field for the Eagles. Runners on first and second. The 0-1 pitch. Hits that one back up the middle. Clark will take that himself. And the unassisted double play. And Caruthers will try to build off of that. Down 4 here in the bottom of the seventh. On your home for high school sports, play on sports.com. Bottom of the seventh, Caruthers down 4. Fireball pitcher Danny Perez cruising through 6, only allowing 4 runs, striking out 6, letting his defense play for him. Fireball has done a great job playing defense behind their star-studded pitcher. Danny Perez looking for his 13th win on the season, facing the 6-7-8 batters, and Christian Arredondo, the number 9 batter, if runner gets on. Perez has been attacking the strike zone all day with fastballs and curveballs. Misses inside on that breaking ball. Dallin Cornelius, the pitcher, just looking to get on base. Caruthers needing 4 runs.
Yeah, and it's good that Garcia's going to have to talk to him because Caruthers looked like he's like, all right, I'm getting this guy on these first two pitches. And, you know, they were a little wild and completely off the mark.
And that's what a great catcher will do. He just feels it. He knows when his pitch is a little off. And Perez comes back with the strike over to first. Perez doing a good job in getting over to first in time. Gets Cornelius out. 3-1 for the first out.
Yeah, you might have said, hey, man, just calm down, right, man.
Right. Just throw strikes. Because you know what? Yeah. Even if you give up a home run in that situation, you're still up 3.
Right. Just throw it over the plate, man. Let us do it. Let's do what we're supposed to do out here.
And facing the bottom of the lineup, not going to do that much damage. Mm-hmm. Breaking ball inside for ball 1.
Although Caruthers has a few hitters on their team, but, you know, tonight just hasn't seemed to be going their way, and it's a lot due to this pitching effort. Ooh, oh, come on.
Perez.
You kidding me?
Cat quickness. Snags that one. Throws it over to first. Two outs. Needing one more out to become Division 5 Central Section champions.
Hey, that was as cool as the other side of the pillow. He just kind of snagged that right out of the air. Said, I got this, guys. Don't, you guys stay relaxed.
Everyone
second, third.
Stay put.
It's cool. It's cool. I got this. We're going home champions, and it's on my back.
Number 8 batter, Matt Unland. Swing and a miss. Pinch hitter. Albert Gonzalez now at bat. Thank you to my statistician and wonderful helpers behind me. I hope you are having a wonderful day like we are up here. Great mix of music and flavor.
You're a great research team. Top of the notch research team.
Here in the city of Caruthers.
Uh-oh.
Perez needing one more strike as the fans of Fireball, the city of Fireball, rising to their feet. Perez, the pitch. Oh. The check swing.
Perez kind of fell off that mound like he was kind of going to do a backflip or something. I'll be surprised what he's going to do after getting this strike.
The pitch. Breaking ball. Strike three. Second-year head coach Eric Salcedo and the Fireball Eagles become Division 5 Central Section champions. Well, Robert, I would ask you who our player of the game is going to be, but I don't think that even needs to be asked.
It's not necessary, man.
If you, the fans at home, have been watching this game like we have, I think we know who's going to get it. Starting pitcher Danny Perez, 13th win on the season. The stat line goes like this. 4 hits, 6 Ks, 0 earned runs. That's about as good as it gets for the pitcher, Danny Perez. And what a way to go out, a senior, Division 5 section, Central Section champions. And we'll be back shortly on here on your home for high school sports with our player of the game interview, Danny Perez. Be back in a few.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream.
Camera 3.
Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on 1. For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.